My name is Alfred Zerfus, a young oldie at 84. No problems. The older you are, the longer you live. In terms of the process from the struggle to success, there is no magic bullet, no single tool. It's rather a mixture that can change over time. For me, core values assessment, self-awareness, a mentor, a higher power, acting on serendipity and accepting others' point of view are important. Even the first sign of success in my contribution to others continues that process. First, some background. For almost 50 years, I worked as a public health doctor in some 25 low-income countries. In emergencies due to war, in nutrition and health, as well as national surveys and studies as an epidemiologist at UCLA. This was for the UN, such as UNICEF and WHO, governments and other agencies such as Save the Children. I invented a special arm circumference measuring tape to assess young child malnutrition. This became standard equipment in emergencies for UNICEF and other agencies. I also developed a quality control procedure used by the UN in training for surveys. Having so-called retired some 12 years ago, I returned to Melbourne, Australia from the US and started addressing health and social issues with graphic presentations and videos for non-government organizations. I continued working in Bangladesh and India, but on a limited scale. I really felt a bit useless and not continuing my prior sense of purpose or contribution. So I attended personal development and social media courses and conferences. A personal mentor helped my discovery. It was okay to be different. I also started talking with my mother as an equal, a dominant force in my life, and had died 30 years before. I want to please you, but I have to be me, as I said to her. This helped my mindset greatly. Another self-discovery exercise was a survey which showed my major core values were humor, innovation, and curiosity, reinforcing the strength of my passions. A combination of these tools helped me focus on my present major work, to use song, music, to promote health and social issues. And working on others' points of view provided the innovation to get more insight into their emotions and actions. I performed a song at a local festival about having leprosy, in which I'd worked for 3 years in India. I was singing how it affected me as the patient. Leprosy, it's crawling all over me, etc. Other examples on YouTube, a video in which I was a tree, a famous elm tree in the center of Melbourne, and how I breathe oxygen for a needy bystander. Also getting a pacemaker operation, preparation, going to the theater, conversing with the operator, and tearing off all my leads before discharge. Ah, that was good. Now I'm on the road to success. Song and music has been well studied in the effects of improving health, but its use in promoting messages has been neglected by agencies. It's time people acted. Recently, the coronavirus outbreak has focused attention enhanced by online news, controversy, and video. Using the outbreak as an entry point, I've posted 4 song videos with a musician, which pertain to official health messages, all on YouTube. The wider goal is to use song music to promote health and social issues, as well as to improve communication elsewhere, in science, data presentation, news, basic education, etc. Song is a way for people and institutions to connect positively through emotion. It's part of Indigenous communities in Australia and elsewhere. The West has lagged behind and needs to catch up. My plan includes starting a non-for-profit organisation, a web page, further research, including interviews of relevant songmakers and interested parties, and connecting with an academic institution and business for collaboration. I'd be willing to get your comments. Thank you.